Becky Kaysen is an active 55-year-old woman who was always on the move. An avid traveler and hiker, Becky considered herself in good physical condition until she started feeling short of breath and was diagnosed with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, and emphysema in 1999. For years, Becky pushed through life with lung disease until she became so sick in 2013, a lung transplant became the only option.
I was elated. I was all for it.
You felt so bad that you knew that this is what was needed and you were excited?
Yes, absolutely. I had no reservations about it whatsoever. It was just like an answer to my prayers.
Cardiothoracic surgeon Dr. Brian Whitson is one of three surgeons from the OSU Wexner Medical Center who performed the lung transplant on Becky in August of 2013. He's pleased with her progress. 9 months later, Becky is feeling stronger and is back at work.
You know, slow at first, but you know, you had to build your strength back up and your stamina. And I told myself, I'm bound and determined, I'm going to keep this up, I'm going to keep exercising, and again, it's the key.
This is an example of what damaged lungs look like. Compare that to this example of a healthy donor lung that was used in a transplant operation. You can clearly see the donor lung is clean and clear. The problem for patients waiting for a lung transplant is that our lungs are considered fragile organs, and it's a challenge to find a donor who has undamaged lungs. To improve the odds for lung transplant patients, Dr. Whitson is involved in researching a process called ex vivo organ perfusion. It basically means cleaning, repairing, and assessing lungs, making them more viable for transplantation. This process is already being used in Canada and Europe, and FDA studies are underway in the United States.
We're, you know, circulating through, you know, an antibiotic solution, you know, that has the properties of that solution that pulls out water out of the lungs. So we really are kind of cleaning them out, you know, cleaning out any bacteria that are there and repairing them so that they're able to be used for transplant.
Dr. Whitson hopes that the perfusion process is FDA approved and becomes more mainstream in the next 3 to 5 years. And his research is allowing Ohio State to be ready to use the perfusion process once it's approved. Dr. Whitson is now expanding his organ transplant research with hopes of improving and repairing all organs before a transplant for a better outcome for patients.
If we have the ability to better assess that function of the donated organ, and also then to take that ischemic time or the time outside the body from 4 to 6 hours to 12, 24 hours, you can really start then looking at organ transplants for the best recipient for that organ. And that may be somebody who's 1,000 miles away. But currently we don't have that option.
Becky is thankful for her donor and the lungs that are allowing her to breathe and to live.
I would love to know who my donor was and meet the family. Here I go. I'm sorry. And I am working on that right now.